welcome to our very last lesson for this semester from the 21st century literature from the Philippines and the world. So last month, or from mga last months nga nahitabo nato, we have been talking about the literature from the Philippines. But right now, we are going to talk about the 21st century literature from the world. So this is a combination of Module 5 and Module 6. Right, so we are going to talk about the world's most famous literary works and writers. So these nations has the most famous literary works and writers, and let's try to see it. What are the world's most famous literary works and the writers, right? So in Asia, we have here a 1Q84 by Haruki Murakami. So 1Q84 is about a young woman named Aomame follows a taxi driver's enigmatic suggestion and begins to notice puzzling discrepancies in the world around her. She has entered, she realizes, a parallel existence, which she calls 1Q84. Q is for question mark. So 1Q84 is a novel by Haruki Murakami. Okay, so that is one of the most famous writers and literary pieces from Asia. Then we also have the Banyaga, A Song of War by Charlson Ong. So Banyaga or A Song of War is about a novel that spans nearly a century of Filipino history as it recounts the life, times, and fortunes of three immigrants from the 1920s and the Commonwealth and the war to the new millennium, who, like other foreigners, were deemed to have no place in the Filipino imagined community. So this is all about a foreigner who, during the war, left their place to live on a foreign country. So that is all about the Banyaga, or A Song of War. Then we have the North America. In North America, there is one of the famous novels that we can find is The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald. So The Great Gatsby is a story about set in a jazz age in New York. So katong mga panahon na nga ninglambo ang jazz music. So the novel tells a tragic story of Jay Gatsby, a self-made millionaire, and his pursuit of Daisy Buchanan, a wealthy young woman whom he loved in his youth. So this is about a love story, a tragic love story. And that's one of the most famous novels in North America. Another one is The Scarlet Letter by Nathaniel Hawthorne. So the novel is set in a village, or this novel is about a girl this novel is set in a village in a Puritan New England. So Hester is believed herself a widow, but her husband Roger Chillingworth arrives in New England very much alive and conceals his identity. So he finds his wife forced to wear the scarlet letter A on her dress as punishment for her adultery. Since this novel is about adultery, and this during this era wherein the novel was written, or the setting of the story of the novel is katupaning way back the time wherein when you commit adultery you will be punished. Oh, so naiuban nga you will be stoned to death. Oh, naiuban nga ihang tungod kay nag-adultery. So in this novel, she was forced to wear the letter A that stands for adultery. So that is one of the very famous novels in North America. Now we move on to Europe. So in Europe, we also have the novel The Little Prince by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. So this story is about a prince, a little prince, kung ano niya sa kagamay, kung sa ato pa murag dawende, so gamay lang, sa dyang a prince. So I want you to watch this and read if you have the book, or if you can find the book. So the story follows a young prince who visits various planets in space, including Earth, and addresses themes of loneliness, friendship, love, and loss. So despite its style as a children's book, The Little Prince makes observation about life and human nature itself. So this is a very must read. So I want you to read this. The Little Prince by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. But The Little Prince is also in a movie that can be watched somewhere. I don't know if... yes, nasa just a Netflix. So it can be watched in Netflix. Another pride of Europe is The Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. So Pride and Prejudice follows the turbulent relationship between Elizabeth Bennet, the daughter of a country gentleman, and Fitzwilliam Darcy, a rich aristocratic landowner. So they must overcome the titular sins of pride and prejudice in order to fall in love and marry. So this is a love story about Mr. Darcy and Elizabeth Bennet. So it is also it was also translated into a movie. So you better watch it because it's for you to be able to know what it is. Then we have here the Latin America. In Latin America, we have The 100 Years of Solitude by Gabriel Garcia Marquez. So 100 Years of Solitude tells the story of the fictional Colombian town Macondo and the rise and fall of its founders. The Buendia family, Macondo fights off plagues of insomnia, war, and rain. But mysteries are spun out of almost nothing. So 100 Years of Solitude. And we also have The House of Spirits by Isabel Allende. The House of Spirits takes place in Chile and tells the story of four generations of characters, beginning with the intersection of the Del Valle family and the Treba family before the start of World War I. So the setting is before World War I. Right, so that is one of the famous novels in Latin America. Then we move on to Africa. Okay, so from Africa, we have here Things Fall Apart by Chinua Achebe. Okay, so the novel chronicles the life of Okonkwo, the leader of an Igbo community, from the events leading up to his banishment from the community for accidentally killing a clansman. Through the 7 years of his exile to his return, and it addresses a particular problem of emergent Africa, the intrusion in the 1890s of white missionaries and colonial government into tribal Igbo society. So traditionally structured and peppered with Igbo proverbs, it describes the simultaneous disintegration of its protagonist Okonkwo and of his village. So this is all about a tribe in Africa. So Things Fall Apart by Chinua Achebe. Then another one in Africa is the Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. And this is based in Nigeria. So, which is the purple hibiscus, half of a yellow sun. So, that is written by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. So, the story is about the lives of Ogwo, a young boy from a poor village Ulana, a middle-class woman, and Richard, a white man and a writer, intersects in intimate and unexpected ways during the vicious Nigerian Civil War. So this is one of the most famous novels in Africa. Right, so activity number one, let's try to do this. Supply what is being asked in the table below. So I want you to write it in a bond paper or any paper so that you can picture it later on afterwards, okay? And post it on the comment section on the page. Right, now let's move on to Module 6, which is the introduction of the different 21st century literary genres across the globe, or the different genres, the 21st century genres. Right, the first one is a comedy. In a modern sense, comedy is a genre of fiction that refers to any discourse or work generally intended to be humorous or amusing by inducing laughter, especially in theater, television, film, stand-up comedy, books, any other medium of entertainment. Oh my. All right, then we have the tragedy. Okay, wait. Then we have the tragedy. The tragedy is a form of drama based on human suffering and mainly the terrible or sorrowful events that befall a main character. So traditionally, the intention of tragedy is to invoke an accompanying catharsis or a pain that awakens pleasure for the audience. So for example of this is The Fault in Our Stars. So I know most of you already know the story of The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. So that is an example of tragedy. Another one is the Romeo and Juliet. Then we have the tragic comedy. So it is a literary genre that blends aspects of both tragic and comic forms, most often seen in dramatic literature. So the term can describe either a tragic play, which contains enough comic elements to enlighten the overall mood, or a serious play with a happy ending. So for example is My Girl. Then we have the thriller. Thriller is a genre of fiction having numerous, often overlapping subgenres. Thrillers are characterized and defined by the moods they elicit, giving viewers heightened feelings of suspense, excitement, surprise, anticipation, and anxiety. Then we have the horror. The horror is a genre of speculative fiction which is intended to frighten, scare, or disgust. The horror genre has ancient origins with roots in folklore and religious traditions, focusing on death, the afterlife, evil, the demonic, and the principle of thing embodied in person. Then we have the historical. It is a literary genre in which the plot takes place in a setting located in the past. An essential element of historical fiction is that it is set in the past and pays attention to the manners, social conditions, and other details of depicted period. So, for example of historical genre is the General Luna. Then we have the romance. A romance novel or a romantic novel is a type of novel and genre fiction which places its primary focus on the relationship and romantic love between two people and usually has an emotionally satisfying and optimistic ending. For example is The Princess Switch, which is available on Netflix already. And The Princess Switch again. Okay, so that is an example of romance. Then we have the fantasy. Fantasy is a genre or speculative fiction set in a fictional universe, often inspired by real-world myth and folklore. Its roots are in oral traditions, which then became fantasy, literature, and drama. In popular culture, the fantasy genre predominantly features settings of a medieval nature. For example, if that is the BFG, wherein It is inspired by real world myth and folklore, which is the giants, okay? Then we have the magic realism. The magic realism, also known as magical realism or marvelous realism, is a style of fiction and literary genre that paints a realistic view of the modern world while also adding magical elements. For example of that is The Life of Pi. Then we have the realistic literature. Realistic fiction is a genre consisting of stories that could have actually occurred to people or animals in believable setting. These stories resemble real life, and fictional characters within these stories react similarly to real people. For example, is The Day After Tomorrow. So, mga realistic literature. Alright, so let's watch it. I want you to watch a famous literary piece formed into a movie such as The Kite Runner, Pride and Prejudice, The Great Gatsby, The Little Prince, Life of Pi, Romeo and Juliet, and or General Luna. And answer the following questions afterwards. So I want you to watch one movie from the following. So, and answer this question after watching it, okay? Alright, so that would be all, and thank you so much for listening, and goodbye.